Hey guys, this is Toph, and today I just want to show you guys this battle and do a very comprehensive battle analysis. It's been a really long time since I showed myself lose on my channel, which, you know, okay, the reason I haven't really been showing myself lose is because most of my losses have been kind of like, either one, I'm just kind of messing around, so I'm just playing badly. There's really nothing to learn from it or do anything like that. It's just kind of like whatever, and then, you know, either the commentary I'm doing is not good because I'm just butthurt, or it's just, what for whatever reason, it just hasn't, I haven't had any good losses. It's always either been lag or me just playing bad or me just not being funny while I've been trying to record. So it's like, I'm not playing my best, but also it's not like it was funny or anything. So it's just, what, you know, whatever. I just don't want to show losses like that. Now, I'm not saying I don't lose. I lose all the time. But yeah, I just don't usually like to show them because I just don't find them entertaining or valuable. But I had 9 matches with this guy, and I'm probably showing some kind of background from one of the matches I'm not really going to be showing for the actual analysis. Well, maybe I'll just show the battle. I'll just show the battle that I am analyzing, I guess. I don't know. And you can see what you think of it before I actually go and slow it down and go point by point. Whatever. I don't know. I'm doing this before I actually edit the video, so I don't know, man. But anyways. But yeah, I played this guy 9 times, and I lost every single time. 2 times I got extremely close. 1 time he literally couldn't even see his health. He literally had no red pixels left of health. So it was insane. And then another time where he still had like really, really low health. Like you barely see it. And then he almost 2-stalked me like twice. And then the rest of them were kind of like semi-close matches where you'd have like low orange red health left when he beat me. Or like high health red when he beat me. Well, he did beat me every single time out of 9 matches. So I'm not saying, it's obvious that he's just better than me. And I will say that the lag was there a little bit, but it was not at all bad. Like, the only exception to that actually was the very last match, which I think he noticed it too. I think that's why he left, was because the last match did get really laggy and he just kind of resorted to abusing jutsu because it was just so laggy that we couldn't really play normally. And it was really annoying and bad. So I probably won't show anything from that one. But regardless, even if you discount that one, 8 very good losses that I think there's a lot to learn from. So this first video, I'm actually probably going to do more multiple videos on this whole session that I did with him. But for this first video, I want to take this very first match I did with him. So I wasn't really like prepared for his playstyle or anything. I just want to show like the very initial match. And I just want to kind of break it down exactly what I did wrong, what I did right, what he did wrong, what he did right. And just, it's kind of weird though too, because really there wasn't a ton of mistakes made, especially by him. He made less mistakes than me. It's probably part of the reason why he won. But even I didn't make like tons of mistakes or anything. I just didn't play as well as him, so that's why I like this match, because I was actually playing decently well. It's just he was playing better, and there's things to learn from this match. And I'll post losses if I'm just playing around and I say funny things while I'm losing. You know, I need to, whenever I'm playing live, I just need to not freak out so much and just deal, you know, whenever I'm playing live, I just need to play less seriously, because if I'm trying to commentate, I can't play to my max potential. It's just not a thing if I'm trying to talk while doing it. I just can't do it. I don't know. Some people have good enough brains, I guess, to be able to like at least get like 75% of their power, but I just get so reduced. I just can't do it. But anyways, let's move on to the actual thing. So right off the bat, I use a new trick I learned from Itachi Uchiha 964, which I'm trying to think of like an exact term of what to call it, but it's a good initiation, especially for people who are ninja moving, which if you notice here, he is ninja moving. So what I do is I use a support dash and then I use an air dash for my leader, and it's a little more stunny. It stuns longer than just doing a support dash and a normal leader dash at the pretty much the same time. And it catches people. I mean, if they're ninja moving, they're pretty much caught. Like, I'm sure there's ways to do switches and stuff to prevent it, but I'm pretty sure even if you counter, it pretty much doesn't prevent it, because the first character will just hit you first and then your counter will do nothing. You'll get stunned and the second character will hit you. So it's really, really good against people who are ninja moving. I'm really excited to use it against Minato runners. I haven't fought a Minato runner since I've learned this new technique. Anyways, yeah, so that works. Basically, okay, so here, he tries to kind of like re-enter the fight, tries to re-engage me, or continue the engagement. And he fails because I got really, really lucky. I think I was trying to do a buffer dash, which I'll put some of the definitions of things I'm saying down in the description below because I haven't done my terminology video, but I'm calling it a buffer dash. But I failed at the buffer dash and I caused my support to jump, which blocked his support's air dash. And then I dashed into his normal dash. Like, he was expecting that to stun me and then to get me. So I managed to get that. And then here I just whiffed because I was just too slow. And Mass Band's air combos are kind of weird. Like, they're really good in some ways. It's really good in some ways, but it's kind of bad in other ways. So he easily took advantage of the whiff, and he got me, and then he hit me with the item, and he basically just took the very solid lead there. I mean, for this part, there's really just not much to say. He just gets me with the freaking till. I should have just blocked, and I just didn't. I don't know. That was just me being stupid. So here, I think I meant to do a support dash, but I failed. So this is just like a kind of physical error. That might have been part of the that might have been lag's fault, honestly. I'm not sure, but I might have just messed it up. I don't know. But that's just like a physical error. I did the right thing in my head. It just didn't work out. And then, so he gets me in the air, and I wait for a decent time to sub, and then I retaliate, and I manage to kind of delay the hit and get a support air combo in. And so I think I guess that one was kind of an even encounter. I might have won that encounter slightly, but overall it was pretty even. So here I kind of managed to get him with just mashing because he was trying to move around in the air. And then to escape my leader dash, he ninja dashes with Tsunade and switches to Tobirama, but he then tries to play defensively by throwing a bomb, but I just dash into him to kind of like negate his guard, and then Mask Man hits him with a jutsu. I probably should continue my offense, but I may have been stuck in the air. I'm not really sure. I need to learn exactly what causes you to kind of not be able to move. I don't know. There's lots of little random things that get you stuck, whether in the air or on the ground too. And I need to learn all that stuff. And so that's something I just need to learn. But, you know, I don't really think I made any actual mistakes here. It's just some things worked out and some things didn't. So it was just kind of a weird encounter overall. But I do need to focus on learning what gets you stuck. All right, so here he initiates me and he just dashes right in front of me, stops in mid-dash and starts comboing. And this is something I need to incorporate into my own gameplay. I need to do that more. And also I need to learn how to deal with it. I guess I could have just countered, but if I would have countered too early, it would have gotten me the dash. He could have done anything else to me. So that's a kind of a weird, I don't know, I guess I don't really know exactly in my head what I need to be done, like what I need to learn how to deal with that, but I do need to learn how to deal with that. Also, I do want to mention that I also, if you notice here, I countered and I was trying to jailbreak, but I guess because the water was kind of like, it was technically a projectile and not his actual physical hits, I guess it didn't count. That's kind of a weird, I bet you can ninja move out of that, maybe. I'm not 100% sure, because it did let me counter, let me do it, but I just couldn't actually, it didn't actually counter him, so that's an interesting thing that I need to figure out on Tobirama's combos, if you can do a tilt break or just ninja move out of his combo. That's definitely something I need to practice and learn to see if it's possible. So here I avoid the dash by jumping, but I do take some chip damage from Donzo. And I try to go in, but I get blocked by Donzo with attacks. He doesn't take advantage of it, but I don't really think that was a mistake on his part because he was a little bit below on chakra and I think subs too. So, you know, that was just kind of a very weird exchange that didn't really, I guess neither of us really took any significant advantage there. I guess maybe he technically did a little more since he got that chip damage off, but neither of us really did much in that. So here he throws a tag, but I switch and avoid it. And then he tries to kind of reinitiate by ninja dashing, but my chakra dash overrides it. I use a support combo, but it seems like I couldn't dash with my leader, I guess. Like, it was kind of weird. I don't really know exactly what happened there. But I need to look. That's just kind of another thing where you get kind of stuck and vulnerable, and I need to learn what exactly causes that. And after he subs my second air combo, I probably should have dashed. I believe I had enough chakra, and I probably would have avoided the tag if I would have just dashed him. So I definitely lost that exchange, but it wasn't huge loss, I guess, but it was weird. Okay, so here he initiates with Tsunade's tilt, and then he switches, and he breaks my guard, and he does about half combos with her damage. It wasn't a very long exchange, but he obviously won it. That's a really good technique. It's a little bit risky because if I could have dashed, I think I did have enough chakra dash, and I could have probably overridden her tilt, I think. Maybe I'm pretty sure you can override that tilt with a dash. It's something I need to look up. But yeah, I should have seen that coming. I mean, I knew that was probably going to come. I think I just didn't react fast enough. I should have just countered him. Either countered him, dashed Tsunade to avoid being hit by it in the first place or getting hit and being able to hit him. Or once I failed to do that, I should have just countered. So there was a lot I could have done to make that not have worked so well, but I just didn't. So that was well played by his part, but I think that was really more my mistake than his good, if that makes sense. So here he initiates with a standard support and leader dash at the same time, and he got me because I was ninja moving. I probably could have maybe just blocked that, but I think I ninja moved again. I don't really know. I'm not sure if he just got me no matter what there, or if I could have managed to block that. I'm really not sure. But I think this was actually a physical error because I believe I was trying to bunny hop away. I don't think I intended to ninja move. I'm pretty sure Okay, well, I did jump first. I don't know. That was weird. I think I was trying to bunny hop, but I'm not 100% sure. That might have been just me being stupid, but I think that was just a physical mistake. And then I tried to retaliate, but he just easily stops me with a dash, and we just chuck our clash, or dash clash, or whatever. So I initiate with a support dash, leader air dash, and it succeeds because he was ninja moving. Again, see, it works really well if they're ninja moving. He tries to retaliate with a dash, but I do a buffer dash, and it wins out because my support blocks him. And then I'm pretty sure this was on accident. I don't think I intended to disengage with the jutsu. I'm pretty sure I meant to just continue going after him. Because yeah, I had him in the combo. I think I just accidentally got myself chakra loaded before I switched with Mask Man. So when I entered, it forced me to do a jutsu. I'm pretty sure that's what happened there. So yeah, I did not intend to do that, but you know, it was an okay exchange. I think I still won the exchange, but just not by as much as I could have. They just kind of like starts approaching me with some basic stuff. And then here, though, this is the interesting part. So I dash at him, and he calls Tobirama, and he dashes at me with Danzo, switches to Tobirama, and it gets me. And I thought that I had stopped Tobirama by dashing into him. I thought Tobirama wasn't going to be a threat anymore, but apparently he was, and he still got me. And so that's interesting. I think Tobirama's jutsu maybe has a little bit of invincibility frames, at least it dashes. I don't know. Maybe it's because it was a support when I first dashed into it, and then he switched to it afterwards. I'm not really sure exactly. But I mean, if you dash into supports, usually they get negated if you dash. I don't know. It's a little bit weird. The rules are a little inconsistent on that. It's not, they don't get negated nearly as easily as they did in Revolution, but still, that was weird. I mean, I need to think about that and see if there's other ways to utilize that, but it was a good move on his part, especially if it was intentional. I don't know if that was an intentional thing he did or if it's just something that kind of worked out, but either way, I mean, that's good, and he definitely won that whole engagement. All right, so here I try to do a support dash, but he just easily stops with a kunai, and I jutsu with Kakashi against his guard. I should have just switched and pressured his guard, but I didn't, and then it didn't work out for me. Okay, so this whole part is pretty interesting. So we both air dash each other, and we both switch. And I don't know if he did something weird or if he just switched before I did, so his leader got stunned by my support and my switch won out. I'm not sure exactly what this is, but I do think there's definitely a lesson to be learned here. I think it might be beneficial to kind of delay switches in these kind of situations because of this, but I need to test this out more or look at other situations where similar things have happened and see if there's a more definite causation or if my Kakashi just kind of beat him out. I don't really know exactly why this is the way it is. So I try to counter air dash him, but if you look here, I dashed to where he was. I think I dashed a little too early, so I dashed to where he was, and then he subbed out of that position, and then so I was left open, and he managed to get me, and then he tries to continue the conflict by dashing me after I recovered from his air combo, but I just counter him, and I hit him with the bomb. He subs, dashes, and uses his support, but I counter him again, negating his support and the dash, obviously, and getting yet another strike back and hitting him with another bomb. So this is one of the few engagements I think I definitely won overall. I got a lot more damage overall in this whole engagement than he did, and this was probably my best part of the game, really. All right, so here he forces me to ninja move, and he catches me with a dash. I probably should have either dashed back at him or just countered. That was a decent move on his part. He kind of zoned me into that, and there were things I could have done, but I just didn't. So I think that was just my mistake. I need to learn how to deal with it when I am kind of zoned like that. And so then after I sub, he attacks in the air, and then I try to jutsu, but he managed to dash in. And that's another thing I need to practice, is I need to practice with all my characters exactly when you can kind of hit in the air and then dash. Because some characters get kind of locked more than others, and it's a weird thing. And then I just sub and run because I have less chakra and not... Or I have less subs and very little chakra left, so I just run, which was probably the right thing to do. So he dashes at me, and I try to do this trick where you do a support dash right as they're hitting you, and it kind of makes it so that you just have priority over them and you can get them, but I failed, and the support does manage to actually hit him. I did it too early, so the support still got him, but I subbed anyways, which was a mistake because he would have been unable to take advantage of that. And then he tries to counter, but I tag and combo. That was pretty good of me. And then he subs, and I try to buffer dash, but his tilt overrides it, that's pretty interesting. That's kind of crazy that the tilt can override that. Tilts are weird. Like, they override weird things, and they get overrided by weird things. Tilts are kind of inconsistent. I need to think more about tilts. and I need to implement them into my gameplay more with some people. Some of them, they don't have good tools. But anyways, so then, let's see, he air dashes me, and he gets me an air combo with his new leader. I recover from the air combo and catch him with a dash. Then I fuck up Kakashi's tag infinite, and he starts comboing. I get away from the dash, but, or I get away and dash, but his, but his combos override my dash, which this is something I really dislike. I don't like it whenever someone's comboing and you dash them from the front and they hit you out of your dash. I think that's kind of bullcrap. I wish dashes always overrode combos. I think that's kind of an inconsistent thing in this game and just in general. So I don't really like that. Anyways, I try to support Ninja Dash, but his Ninja Dash hits both my leader and my support. I think what caused this, I think I did it a little too early. I think I needed to delay it a little bit more so it hits just my support first and then switch, but it's kind of a weird thing. I'm not really sure exactly what to do to stop that from happening, but definitely something I need to look into and see other examples of. And then I try it again, and this time I kunai, and I do stop him, but he hits me with an air combo, and I have no choice but to sub. And then I whiff an attack after subbing. I should have ninja dashed. I mean, he had no chakra. He couldn't have done anything about it. And then I try to approach, but then he just kunais me to death, and the first round is over. But here I use both of my jutsus because I really just wanted to whittle down his health without having to drain all of his subs. And what I should have done here is I should have started with Kakashi instead of starting with Masked Man because I could have zoned him better with Kakashi and then used Masked Man. I don't think it would have worked either way, but it would have been better. The idea behind it, what I was trying to do there was okay, but I just didn't implement it very well. And so then he gets chip damage with Donzo, but he used him as a support and he dashed into me, which caused me to kind of like be stuck and have to block, and then he got the Donzo hit me. So, I mean, this was kind of a, neither of us really won out a lot in this exchange, but he got the chip damage off, so he definitely won. And that's kind of the theme of this whole battle. He won just more exchanges than me, that's why I lost. Okay, so I avoid his dash here by jumping, and I dash him from the air, but he dashes me from the ground, and it overrides my dash. And I looked at this so many times in such slow motion, and I think, look, if you notice, my chakra doesn't go down when I try to dash here. And I think what it is I think for some reason I ninja dash before I hit the chakra button, I guess, and it just forced me to do a ninja dash instead of a chakra dash. This happens to me later too, so I don't know if this is my mistake or if it's just lag. I don't really know what this is. I need to look at more of my gameplay when I know for sure it's not laggy and see if this ever happens to me then. But this was really weird, and it happens again later too. Anyways, so then I sub his air combo and he air dashes me. Right as he hits me, I switch in the air and I win the air fight. This is a really good thing to know, and I need to practice it and see if it's if it's a consistent way to deal with the being vulnerable in the air after you sub or after you switch, and see if this always works. So this is really interesting. I'm gonna show this a bunch of times. I'm just gonna keep playing it in repeat probably and in slow motion as I'm saying all this bullshit. Because if this works very consistently, this is a great tech. And I need to really practice this and really like get a lot of information. The one thing I'm worried about is that it might be dependent on the camera angle. You know, it might be dependent on which direction you switch and which like way the camera is going, because that actually does affect your switches. And so it might not be easily consistent. There might be a lot of kind of zoning things to take into account here. But regardless, this was one of the more interesting things that I definitely want to learn more about and see if I can utilize in the future. So here he initiates by tilting with Donzo and then using Tsunade, and he switches to Tsunade as she's using her jutsu, which this jutsu is so good and powerful. It's just an amazing jutsu, but it does a ton of damage to me. I really should have probably subbed that because that was just too much damage to be taking when I'm already in such a low lead and I have decent amount of subs. So I probably should have subbed that, but we do dash and sub, you know, we do some basic stuff. And then I switched to Kakashi and killed him with a jutsu, which this was a pretty risky move to take, but it ended up being very worth it because I really just needed to get rid of that health without having to worry about training all the dang subs first. So this ended up being worth it, but it was definitely a risky move that might not have paid off. So I don't know if I could recommend doing something like this on a consistent basis, but you know, sometimes you gotta risk it for the biscuit, man. So I fuck up with my support dash. And I think the reason that that happened is because of the round. It's weird, like whenever the round very, very first starts, stuff like that just kind of fucks up. I don't know why. It happens to me a lot, actually. I don't know if I do it a little too early or what the hell, but something happened there with the way the round started, I think. I'm pretty sure that's what fucked me up there. Then he calls Tobirama, who pins me and allows him to get at me with Tsunade. He dash and switch, giving me the opportunity to block, which was a mistake on his part. And then I counter broke Donzo's jail. He was hitting my guard. And then I just countered him and it worked out. So that's a weakness of Donzo. You have to, so if you play Donzo or play against him, that's definitely something to keep in mind there. I'm going to be doing videos on individual characters that'll kind of show stuff like that. I need to learn a lot of those because a lot of the people who are a lot better than me know all those kind of things. So that's it's a very good thing to know. I just kind of do it randomly and hope it works out a lot, which is kind of bad. Anyways, so here I jutsu both Kakashi and Mask Man, and he just easily avoids it somehow and punishes me. I don't think this was a mistake on my part. I think that was actually a decent move on my part because the likelihood of him escaping from that was pretty low, but he just freaking went baller mode and did it. So then I sub and tried to reinitiate, but he blocks and uses his support jutsu with Donzo, and which pins me. And then he tries to jail me with Tsunade, but I do manage to get away. And then I try to dash to initiate him, but he just uses Tsunade's jutsu and we both just kind of whiff our attacks. Like he just kind of goes off into nowhere and I'm just sitting there attacking nothing. So that was just kind of a weird exchange where we both messed up. So here I tried to engage the jutsu, which was a massive mistake because I have literally no support gauge. So I can't do any switches. I have less chakra and subs. So he obviously easily punches me, and then I sub his dash immediately and jump. He dashes at me with the main character, switches, ending up behind me. I hit his support. We fall. He combos me on the ground, which this was like an insane move on his part. Like, you know, he knew what he was doing here. He did this really well, and it's definitely something that I want to learn how to do better and implement. But anyways. So I sub and he tries to guard break me, but I punish him for the guard break. And he subs immediately and I try to punish him by guard jumping and then just hitting him as he dashes into my guard. But my guard breaks. He switches, getting me stuck as I fall and combos me on the ground again. That was obvious. I mean, he's so good at doing that. Like transitioning from the air to the ground is something that he did very well. And I think this is probably one of the main reasons he beat me. Anyways, I did call Mask Man a good time and he managed to get Donzo off me. So I didn't get totally wrecked here, but this could have been a lot worse. But still, I mean, this one and the last one, the way he gets me from the air to the ground is just crazy. The way he's able to so consistently do that. Here I engage with an air dash, which was also another mistake. So here at the end, I'm making all these mistakes where I'm trying to initiate and engage when I really should be playing defense because I mean, I have less subs and no support yet again, even though I have slightly more chakra, this was still just a mistake. And then I get the hits done here, but I don't take advantage of it. And I whiff an air attack. He punishes me with his own air attack. And then he switches to Tsunade in the air. And then he switches to Tobirama as I'm falling. And then Tobirama's freaking OP air combo, which is this guy definitely knows his air combo shit, dude. He knows his air game. And as I'm charging chakra, freaking Tobirama's air combo gets me. So that was a crazy move that he did with all that. But here I try to zone him with Kakashi, but he avoids it and air dashes me. I block the dash and counter dash from the air, and I do manage to get that. He jumps after subbing, I dash him, and he air dashes me and switches. He could have probably attacked me, but I think he was trying to get back to the ground. I didn't expect my air combo to hit him from so far down. This was kind of weird. Like, he got, like, sucked back up into it. So this was kind of a weird thing where he probably really wasn't expecting that to happen. I don't know if I was even expecting that to happen. Like, that was probably just kind of weird bullshit on my side. He subs and we both dash, and I try to switch to Kakashi, but I think I did this a really way too late. And then he hits me with Donzo's tilt here. He gets a strike back and tries to strike back juggle me, but I don't fall for it, luckily. Yeah, that was something that I at least did pretty well. I didn't fall for that bullshit. So here I try to initiate more offense by just air dashing, but I didn't implement any kind of like anti-guard tech, which I just learned some stuff that I need to implement more. I think I didn't expect him to be able to block this. I think that's what happened there, but I'm really just not sure. And look, if you notice here, look how, like, when I hit his guard, right? Look how close I am here. So there are other instances where, like, he'll dash into my guard here later, and I'll show you how far away he is in comparison to this. Like, look how close I am versus how far he's going to be later on. Anyways, I just sub here and block, and I probably should have like initiated more offense more quickly, but I do get lucky with the jutsu. I guess he probably wasn't expecting the jutsu. He opened up his guard right as I did it. So I guess that ended up being a good thing, but it was kind of like a mistake that just kind of happened to work out, really. All right, so for here, again, his air dash overrides mine. At first I was like, do air ground dashes override air dashes? I was like, no, that's obviously not the case. Well, again, if you notice, my Chakra does not go down. So again, I don't know if this is like some mistake I'm doing on a consistent basis or if this was just lag not letting me do what I was trying to do, but this whole thing was kind of weird. I sub right as he switches, which left his new character open, and then I just dash him and do a double air combo on him. And then he subs it and we dash clash and, you know, it's whatever. All right, so here we're both trying to kind of bunny hop and lure each other in, but he kunais me to open my guard and tries to combo me on, or he combos me on the ground. He instantly switches to Sonate. And then I sub and he retaliates with a dash. But look, here's where I was talking about earlier. Notice how far away he is from my guard. And I need to figure out exactly what causes that. What causes some things to end up being closer and farther away from the guard that so that you can attack or not attack after you either hit a guard or don't, or you are the one guarding and they hit you. That's something I need to learn because I don't really quite understand what happens with that. So then he just jutsus with Sonate and gets me, which nearly kills me. Sonate's jutsu does so much damage, so reliable, so good. I sub and he runs into my charge dash aura, which is, I don't really know what to call this tech. This is something I haven't figured out how to call it, but basically, I'll explain it later, but I was trying to do something here and it worked out, kind of. And then he tries to support ninja dash, but I switch, and then he tries to do a kunai entry, but I managed to get the counter in, which is really, anytime anyone like just throws kunai like that, you can almost just get a guaranteed counter on them, because they're almost always just going to combo you right after. So here I failed to use the support dash yet again, which would have been a dumb decision even if I had, like even if it had worked, this was still a dumb decision because I didn't have any subs, like why was I even trying to go after him? But this is, I failed to do this a lot of times and I really don't know whether it's lag. I think the one time it was because of the, like the way the round just started and sometimes things are kind of weird when a round first starts. But yeah, I don't really know. I must have been doing something wrong where I just kept failing so often. Here I do manage to avoid the water wall and I get a bit of combo damage in, and then I avoid like, you know, a few attacks here and I try to grab him because, and the reason I try to grab him is because I know I'm like in a bad situation. I'm like, why did I go in? I need to disengage. So basically I was just trying to grab him so I could disengage and reset a little bit, but he just hits me and I die. So with this whole thing, I think the main things I did wrong was I kind of just, you know, I would whiff attacks in the air. He was really, the main thing is he's just better than me. I mean, honestly, like if we're being real, the main thing is he just did everything a little bit better than I did. And he just managed to win pretty much all the engagements by, even if it was just a little bit, like we would engage each other and he would just win most of the time just by a little bit, but he would always win except for maybe that one where I did actually take a significant amount of his health where he barely got any of mine. Other than that one engagement, he won almost every engagement. He was very good with knowing how to do things in the air. It was very obvious that he's practiced a lot of air tech because he was doing all these things where he was managing to get me on the ground after doing an air combo. And so he was able to continue doing damage while on the ground so he didn't have to sacrifice any damage. He could just keep doing damage. So he just knew a lot of things. And also, so I guess my main mistakes were whiffing. I whiffed a lot where I failed to do my support combo or my support dashes. So that was one thing that I did really badly. I engaged several times when I shouldn't have, where he had either the sub and or the chakra advantage. And so I should have just stayed back and played defense. And then, yeah, so I guess there was those two main things I did wrong, and then there was that main thing that he did right, and he just made very few mistakes. I mean, even when there were a few times where he could have gotten me where I whiffed and he didn't take advantage of it, but most of those times the reason he didn't take advantage of it was because he was behind on some resource. But I think you could argue that those were maybe mistakes of his, but I honestly think that actually ended up working in his favor. And so some things I learned and that I need to kind of take into consideration is the support dash / air dash is such a just epic tool for if they're ninja moving. I mean, if they are ninja moving, you can just use that technique to get them. I mean, they are just gotten. I mean, if they try countering, you get them most of the time, unless you air dash too soon and you kind of hit the dashes both at the same time. And then I realize that I'm doing those mistakes, and then I need to figure out how to do that thing in the air where he dashed me in the air, and then right as he hit me, I switched and got him. So I need to practice with that. That's something I kind of learned, that I am actually the one who did. I need to learn some of his things where he manages to wait perfectly and really bide his time so that he can get me on the ground. I need to learn some of his air tech. And then I need to learn whether I'm making a mistake whenever I accidentally ninja dash when I mean to chakra dash, or maybe that again, that could have been lag. But if I notice that in further gameplays where I know it's less laggy, then I definitely need to work on that. So yeah, there was a lot in that. And this was, I showed this whole match because I wanted to give like a feel for the entire match. I think I am going to do further battle analysis on these other matches I had with him, but I'm not going to do the full match like I did with this one. I think I'm just going to go through every other match I played with him except for that last one. I don't care about that last one. It was too laggy. But all the other ones, I'm going to go through them and I'm going to find specific instances, like those instances where I don't know what happened, or, oh, this is a thing that might be a thing. You know, if I see more instances of like where I did that thing where he dashed me in the air and I switched right as he hit me and got him. You know, if I see things like that in future ones, then I'm going to collect all of those type of instances and put them into one video. Or two if there's a whole shitload. I haven't actually broken down. I've watched all these things, all these fights like twice or maybe even three times on some of them. But I haven't broken them all down yet like I did with this one, so I don't actually know like all the stuff that actually happened. So yeah, I think there's almost certainly more stuff, because I feel like there was a lot more interesting tech. But anyways, I hope you guys managed to learn something from this. I freaking know I did. And so there's a lot of things I just outright learned, and then there's also some things that I need to work on, or I need to figure out exactly what it is about them that I need to learn. So yeah, I'm hoping that in the future I'll be able to take some of these things that I found here and hopefully in some of these other matches that I did with this guy, and I'll be able to show you guys exactly how it is that they work and when to use them and all that kind of good stuff. And so yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I really, really enjoyed these fights with this guy. This was some of my favorite losses in a really long time. I really enjoyed these because it really felt like I was actually being outplayed as opposed to just me being a fucking retard or lag fucking me up. So I really, really enjoyed these fights, and I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I hope you guys enjoy what I show you from this guy in the future. Yeah, props to this guy. He's really, really good. One of the best players I fought, probably. Top five, at least. And yeah, anyways, I've been ranting on for so long, so I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I will talk to you guys in the next video.